one of the most hated, if not the most hated doctrine found throughout all the pages of Scripture, is a teaching that anyone who dies rejecting the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ will spend eternity in the lake of fire. Many unbelievers, if not most, say that the teaching of eternal hellfire is the reason they do not or could not ever believe in the Christian God, because they say it is unfair, cruel, sadistic, offensive, or just plain wrong for people who do not trust in Christ to be tormented for all eternity simply because of a quote-unquote few sins that they may have committed while living here on earth. They also ask angrily how a loving God could do such a thing. After all, they say, a few sins here and there most certainly does not warrant such a horrific punishment. However, they fail to take into account that not only is he a God of love, but he is also a just God, a righteous God, a holy God, a God of wrath, and an eternal God. And just one sin against him is worthy of an eternal punishment. But what is even more insidious than unbelievers denying the eternality of the lake of fire are all the Christians who either deny it out of hand, who try to say that it is simply poetic language, or those who accept heretical doctrines like universalism and annihilationism to explain it all away. Universalism says that all of mankind will be saved at the end, even the devil himself, while annihilationism teaches that unbelievers will simply be extinguished, go out of existence, when God judges them on Judgment Day. Both universalism and annihilationism were belched up from the counsels of Satan, and Christians who reject the lake of fire as eternal are being rebellious to Scripture, and many of them have been led into those heretical beliefs by their apostate denominations, so-called pastors and teachers who refuse to teach or speak on the subject for fear of offending those sitting in the pews, or simply because they stubbornly and willfully refuse to believe it. However, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 16 and 17 says, "All Scripture is given by inspiration of God, and it is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works." The Bible is not a buffet table. It is the inspired and infallible Word of the living God. Therefore, we do not accept or reject what we like or don't like, but as believers, we must believe it all and submit to its absolute authority in all matters of faith and practice. Now, it is true that the lake of fire is a terrifying place to think about, but it is important to remember that our Lord Jesus Christ spoke more about the subject than he did about heaven. Scripture describes it as everlasting burnings and devouring fire, Isaiah chapter 33, verse 14, unquenchable fire, Matthew chapter 3, verse 12, a furnace of fire and a place of wailing and gnashing of teeth, Matthew chapter 13, verses 42 and 50, everlasting fire, Matthew chapter 25, verse 41, everlasting punishment, Matthew chapter 25, verse 46, fire that never shall be quenched, and where their worm dieth not, Mark chapter 9, verses 43 through 48, a place of torment, Luke chapter 16, verse 23, and the place where those who worship and take the mark of the beast will be tormented with fire and brimstone, Revelation chapter 14, verses 9 through 11. Scripture also goes on to say that the wise avoid it, Proverbs chapter 15, verse 24, that the wicked shall be turned into hell, Psalm chapter 9, verse 17, that the beast, the false prophet, and the devil will be cast into the lake of fire, Revelation chapter 19, verse 20, and chapter 20, verse 10, and that we should fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell, Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. Yes, it is both terrifying and frightening. And what's more, it is not a temporal place as many would like to believe, but it lasts forever and ever. If it were a temporal place, then all the scriptures warning against unbelievers going there for all eternity would make absolutely no sense. What must also be stressed is that hell was prepared for the devil and his angels, Matthew chapter 25, verse 41. But if sinful man refuses to believe the gospel in order to be justified before the righteous God, Romans chapter 3, verses 24 through 26, then there will be nowhere else for him to go but to the lake of fire. Once again, God is holy, and he is also eternal, and no sin can or will be allowed in his presence. All sin against him is worthy of an eternal punishment. But the good news is that we do not have to end up in the lake of fire. It does not have to be our final destination, because Almighty God has graciously provided a way of escape. Scripture tells us that, "For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." John 3:16. The Lord Jesus Christ, the sinless Son of God, left the glories of heaven and became our substitute by dying on Calvary's cross and paying our sin debt. And whosoever believes the gospel in simple faith will be saved. John 4 verse 14, John 5 verse 24, Acts chapter 10 verse 43, 1 Corinthians 15 verses 1 through 4, Ephesians chapter 1 verse 13, Hebrews chapter 7 verse 25, 1 John chapter 5 verse 13, Revelation 22 verse 17, and others. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners, 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 15, and Romans chapter 5 verse 8. But those who reject his free offer of the gospel will find themselves at the great white throne judgment, where they will then be cast into the lake of fire for all eternity. Revelation chapter 20, verses 11 through 15. So here's the conclusion of the matter. Those who say that the lake of fire is not eternal are deceivers and liars, because the same God who gives everlasting life to those who trust upon his Son by simply believing the gospel will also damn to the lake of fire for all eternity those who reject his Son and who die in unbelief. As the scripture saith, "Yea, let God be true, but every man a liar." Romans chapter 3, verse 4. I'm Mark Sennett.